Hi all, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we've got Twiggy. Yes, Eddie Stobart's back in the house. Issues 103 and 104. We have got 105 and 106, but I think that'll make it too long of a video. So we'll stick with 103 and 104, then I'll put another video out with 105 and 106. Excellent stuff. Now, I have taken it down. She's on here. So let's have a quick look at the instructions in the magazine and see what it all entails. Okie dokie, issue 103 of Eddie Stobart build. Here we go. Part supplied, mudguard and indicator. So we have the right front mudguard, the right tilting handle, the lens for the right indicator, the mount for the right indicator, DP07 and DDO3 screws. Excellent stuff. So we need to identify which light and which hole. I've already got mine through, to be honest. And can always test them with that. I'll show you that in a minute. So we pop the parts into place. There's the lens, make sure the pattern is on the outside or the rough bit. Put the mudguard in, and that is what we end up with. And issue 104 is exactly the same, I believe. Go through the magazine. British military trucks of World War One. That'll be an interesting read. And left mudguard and indicator. Coming again 104. Anyway, let's get on with the build. Here are the parts, let's get them out. There we go, those are the parts. That's the mudguard, the tilting handle, that's the indicator housing, and that is the lens. We have DP07, DDO3 screws. Now we need the cab. So first of all, we need the tilting handle. That goes here and here. Then points there like that. Just like that. There's a couple of guides either side of that base. And we just need to pop that DDO3 screw into place. I think I need a bit of oil on this. There we go. And here we need a DP07 screw. There we go, excellent. That is that tilting handle in place. Looking brill. Next we need the mudguard. That fits just under there like that. Should fit neatly in line with the chassis. There we go. Yep. That should tuck in there, which it seems to do. Now we need two DP07 screws. The first one, there we go, that's the second one. Excellent, there we go. Oops, brilliant. Right, now we need the lens and the housing for the indicator. So we need to put the lens, which is the orange piece, inside here. Hopefully it will just click into place. It's a bit too small for my hands, this. Let's move this. There we go. Nicely into place. Excellent. Yep, so there's a nearly dropped it then. Now all we need to do is to identify the LED, which is this one, because I have already identified it. Pop that through there, like so. And pop this LED into there. There we go. Excellent. And that should just push into place, just like that. Yep, it sits proud. There we go. That's the side and indicator. Right, now I'll power this up. This is 04 and this is a battery power supply from another build, and there we can actually put that on its side. There we go. So yep, that's how I had identified it earlier. Excellent. Now we can move on to issue 104. Okie doke, issue 104. Let's get the parts out. So with issue 104, we have the left front mudguard, left tilting handle, the mount for the left indicator, lens for the left indicator, DDO3, DPO7 and DDO8 screws, because we have got a little bit more to do in this issue. So we do exactly the same on the opposite side of what we've already done. And then round to the rear mudguards and wheels. So we'll grab them out. We'll grab the chassis, put the mudguards on, put some wheels on, and then we're left with that. Excellent. So there we go. And in issue 105, we have the bar and other details, electrical cables, mounting plate, bushes, blind spot mirror and mount, tie bar, anti-spring bar brackets, power extension cables and a range of screws. Excellent. Let's get on with the build. Okay, so we need the tilting handle in place first. That can go just there. DPO7 DDO3 screw. So we can put the DPO7 screw in first this time. There we go. And now the DDO3 screw. Pop a little bit of oil on there. And that's that in place. Now we need the mudguard shaped like that. Yeah, that's exactly the same as the other one. We need DPO7 screws again for this. There we go, excellent. Now I did identify my LED here. I think that is on number 3, if I remember rightly. So we can power this up. There we go. And the other one on the side. Excellent. So we've got the right LED. And now we need to put the lens in the housing. Again, with the pattern on the outside. That's the straight side, smooth side. That has the pattern on it. Get that lined up, pop that in there like so. Excellent. And then we can pop this, which, let's see, yeah, it's got a bit of rough on that end, that side, so make sure that's pressed in. We'll put it that way around when we've done. First of all, I need to pop the LED through here, and then need to put the, oops, is it, LED in to here. There we go, that's a nice tight fit. And that one's actually gone in better than the other one. No, it does actually. Looking at the, that is well flush, that one's pushed right through. And funnily enough, that one hasn't. And I thought it looked right on the card. Oh, it has nearly. There we go. It looked right with the diagram as well. But yeah, little black pins or legs pop through the. But we can test that again now. Make sure I've not damaged anything. There we go. That's both indicator lights working. Fantastic. Okay, now we've got the chassis, we can put the mudguards into place. Now the mudguards go at the back here. I'll show you the screw holes. Let's grab all of this carefully. There we go. There's one screw hole there and one there. So that will go like that, and there, and need to hold that there like that and screw it in place with two DPR 7 screws. Okie doke. First one in here. There we go, brilliant. And the second one here. Excellent. Now this one, they're exactly the same, but on this side we'll go in there like that. And I can turn this round and we'll screw it from the other side. Okay, now we've got that in position. DPR screw there, and the next one just here. Keeping that supported at the back. There we go. So we don't push it out. Well, let's have another look. There we go. That's both mudguards now in place. Now we can pop some wheels on. Okay, now for this we need DD08 screws, and we need these rear tires. Now this is a double and it will fit. Just there we go. Just keep turning it until it moves on. And now we need to pop in a DD08 screw. Just there. Pop that down. It has got some oil on it, and that's brilliant. Now we can put the hubcap on. I say we can put the hubcap on if it wants to. There it is. Excellent. There we go, that's the first one. Let's get the other one on. There we go. Got it on its side this time. Might make it a little bit easier. Get that tire into place there. There we go. Just keep turning it until it drops. And one DD08 screw. Pop the hubcap on. Excellent, that looks very effective. There we go, excellent stuff. That one moves all right, and so does that one. Brilliant. Well, I don't know why we can't put the front ones on, to be honest. If that goes on there. Yep, got to get the steering linkage on, I suppose. But anyway, we can do that at a later date. Excellent stuff. Okay guys, that is it. That is issues 103 and 104 completed. There is that front chassis. Looking nice and bolly with both rear wheels on. I think in issue 105, we get a steel linkage bar. So we might be putting the front tires on there then. But for now, there's the cab with those mudguards on and the lenses looking excellent. It's funny how that one popped in straight away, and then when you look at the magazine, when I popped that one in, it looks exactly the same as the magazine, but it didn't pop all the way through. It's quite stiff, but it's all in place, looks great. You saw the light test from both, that's fantastic. So if you have got one of these little battery packs from another build, there we go, it's got a little switch on it as well, so doesn't matter that the batteries will be down, connected all the time, it's not draining anything. But that is it, that is issues 103 and 104. So I hope you did like that. If you did, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you soon for issues 105 and 106. Nearly forgot then. Thanks again, see you soon, bye for now.